everyone, and welcome back to my channel. As you could see it already, of course, from the thumbnail and also from the title of this video, today we're going to make a Billie Eilish doll. That's why you have probably clicked on it, and that's why you're probably watching it right now. And you know, about a year ago, I have made already my first Billie Eilish doll, and normally I don't repeat characters, people on this channel. No, wait, I've made Cinderella twice, and I've made Snow White doll also twice. Well, today it's time to make Billie Eilish also the second time, Billie Eilish 2.0. Because, you know, I'm such a huge Billie's fan. I think she's so talented, so fresh, so really, so amazing. Her energy, her music, really just love this girl. And she just keeps me inspiring every day. And since I've been thinking approximately once a week, oh, I should make another Billie Eilish doll, and then I'm all the time stopping myself, saying, no, wait, you've made already one Billie Eilish doll, it's already enough. But anyway, if I still keep thinking about it, I probably should let myself go, and I should probably make the second Billie Eilish doll on this channel, because after all, it's my channel, my rules, nobody's going to stop me. If I want to make here, I don't know, 10 Billie Eilish dolls, I'm free to make it. Nobody's going to watch it probably, but anyway, I'm free to make whatever I want, and this week I want to make a Billie Eilish doll. Well, for this makeover, I've decided to take this Wonder Woman doll. Actually, I've bought this doll to make a mini me doll makeover, so humble me, I've chosen a Wonder Woman to make myself. But you know, I'm looking at this doll right now, and I think I'm going to give this doll to Billie, to this new project, and for myself, I'm going to look for something else, maybe buy the second Wonder Woman doll like this or something. I don't know yet, we will see. And this is actually my problem with this mini me doll. I know you're asking to make one already for years, and I have it also in my planning already for years. But I don't know, there are always some people who are more inspiring for me than myself. I don't know, for me it's more interesting to make a Billie Eilish doll than myself. Doll. Because I know everything about myself and it's not that exciting, but I promise I'm going to make the mini me doll in the nearest future, and today we're going to take this doll and we're going to turn her into another version of Billie Eilish here on my channel. Well, right now we're going to unbox this doll, then we're going to remove her outfit, then we're going to cut her hair very short, so we're going to prepare the canvas. And while I'm working, please don't forget to subscribe to my channel if you're new here. Of course, support my art here on YouTube with your likes. Yeah, and I'm going to start working. And this is a very pretty doll, by the way. I really love her body because all the proportions still look quite healthy, and she's also very bendable. This doll is fully articulated, and I really love that her feet, they also have quite a normal size and shape, so I'm really a fan of this doll. I warm up the head like always with my hair dryer. It will make the rubber soft, and I will be able to disconnect it from the body without damaging the neck, because it's still quite a risky process. Okay, done. Now let's take the tweezers and I'm going to remove the rest of the short hair from the inside of the head. And after this, I'm removing her face with pure acetone. Now I can seal the face with a couple of layers of Mr. Super Clear sealant. It will make the surface matte and I will be able to draw on it easily. So, and after this I start drawing the face. I use like always my watercolor pencils. Some colors are from Faber-Castell, some I prefer from Caran d'Ache Supracolor, and some are from Derwent. And then I add shadows using soft pastels. Between the layers I seal the face all the time with Mr. Super Clear again and again to save my progress and to be able to layer the colors. I've chosen these pictures of Billy as a reference and now I'm trying to recreate them on the doll. Of course, we will not be able to make a complete photographic copy of Billie Eilish. For this you must have a face molded like Billie's face, with the same nose, cheeks, the distance between the nose and the lips, and they're not the same here. But anyway, we will try to grasp the main features to make her in some way like recognizable. So now her face seems quite finished and I'm going to start making her hair. I will use this white yarn for it, and first of all I should like always turn this yarn into hair. And for this I start with cutting the yarn into shorter pieces and tying them around barbecue sticks. Then I make this yarn loose. Brush it. And then I make it straight with this flat iron. My first Billy doll had blue hair like in the bad guy video, and right now I want to recreate her iconic green and black hair, and on this step I want to color the top part of the hair with this green fabric marker. The black part we will add later, but the roots I have to color now before I glue hair to this doll's head, otherwise if we first glue the white hair and then we color it, the roots would stay white. And these white roots, you would be able to see them through the hair, so I'm going to color it now. I let the marker dry for 6 hours. I iron the hair again with a flat iron according to the directions on the packaging. And then I can start attaching the hair to the head using tacky glue. After all the hair got attached to the head, I can also make a hair split. I'm going for the twin buns hairstyle today, so first of all I'm going to make 2 pigtails and then I will color the white part of the hair with a black marker. And after this, when the marker gets dry, I'm going to finish the look, and here it's very important to not draw on her face because this would be fatal. Thank you. Now let's also add a touch of glossy varnish to her eyes and lips, and after this I think her hat has been finished. I still want to blush her body, of course, to make it the same color like the face, but first of all I want to make the outfit for her, otherwise, you know, there is a risk to scratch the body, to damage this blushing, and you know, I have just one doll like this, so let's make the outfit first and then we'll work some extra on the body. Today I've decided to recreate this look for my mini Billy, and I start with making an oversized black t-shirt and a pair of oversized shorts. Then I take green acrylics, a sponge, and I start applying green paint, creating some messy spots of color. And then I add some more detailed accents using white acrylics. So, this is our finished outfit, it looks pretty cool I think, and now let's quickly make a pair of white socks, and after this we will move on to the shoes. Billy wears these white Nike sneakers with this look, so let's try to recreate them out of Warbler thermoplastic. You see, I've already cut out all the parts, and now I'm going to warm them up one by one and connect to each other. So now let's cover them with white acrylics, add some shadows and details with pastels and pencils. Probably I'm also going to add the brand name, so I'm going just to finish them up a little bit. So here are the shoes. They look super adorable, I think. You know, I really love making warbler shoes for my dolls. So don't forget to subscribe to my channel to see more. And now I can finally blush the body to make it the same color like the face. And for this, I'm going to sand her body first using the nail buffers to remove this glossy top from its surface. Then I will spray it with Mr. Super Clear sealant, and then I will apply the same soft pastels we've used already today for her face. I think I still want to give her super long green nails. You know, Billy loves it lately. But honestly, I'm not sure if it would work with this position of her fingers, because these two nails, they would simply like overlap each other. But let's try it anyway, because I think it would be a perfect finishing touch for my doll. And you know what, guys? The position of her hands is just asking for a microphone, really, it's been made for it. So let's make one quickly using a piece of warbler thermoplastic, and after this we'll finally put everything together. So, and here is my brand new mini version of Billie Eilish. And I really love the way she looks, really guys. I'm so happy I've decided to come back to this concept and that I've made this doll, because I felt really super inspired and super excited through the whole working process. And I just couldn't stop adding more and more details when you've just seen it yourself. Nails and the microphone, I couldn't stop. So, thank you so much, Billie, for inspiring me, even though you will never see this video. But by the way, guys, who knows, maybe someone would show it to her or something like this. So please share this video and tag Billie in it, because you know, everything is possible in this world. And now I would love to hear your opinion about this makeover. Of course, I really hope you would love it as much as I do, but who knows? So please don't hesitate to share all your thoughts in the comments down below. And the doll will be available for sale on eBay for 3 days. So if you need this little Billie in your life, please go and check it out. The link is in the description box, like always. So guys, and that was my doll transformation of the week. I really hope you've enjoyed it today. And if so, please don't forget to support my art here on YouTube with your likes. Of course, subscribe to my channel if you're new here. Hit the bell button. And I will see you already very soon, next week Friday, in my new doll repaint video. Love you guys. Bye.